Hello friends, today I am going to discuss what is discrete amplitude signal. In my last video, I have covered what is continuous amplitude signal. Now let me discuss what is discrete amplitude signal. Discrete amplitude signal. Whenever you are discussing a signal, you are representing the signal in this manner. X is a function of time. X is any physical quantity. It may be voltage, it may be current, it may be electric field intensity, it may be magnetic field intensity, it may be any physical quantity that is a function of time. Here this T is the independent variable and this X is the dependent variable. Generally, whenever you plot this signal, this is time axis, this is your X is a function of time. That means in this axis, which is known as abscissa, you are taking time. In this axis, which is known as ordinate, you are taking X. So this X is known as amplitude, T is time. That means this X, you are considering this axis, which is known as amplitude axis. So with respect to amplitude, the signal having two classification, one is a continuous amplitude signal and other is discrete amplitude signal. With respect to time, also signal having two classification, one is a continuous time signal and other is a discrete time signal. And continuous time signal, discrete time signal, continuous amplitude signal, I have already discussed. Now let me cover discrete amplitude signal. What is this discrete amplitude signal? Whatever the signal you have, first of all, before defining, you just imagine a set. I have told in almost all my discussion, whatever the signal you have, first define a set. Now here you are discussing discrete amplitude signal. That means you have to imagine a set of amplitudes first. And if within the set you are putting some discrete values, that means suppose I am having a set. This is suppose a 2, 4. Now this is a set. Now if the values of the signal, see, if the values of the signal are only 2 or 4, the signal value cannot be any other value rather than 2 or 4. That means, suppose this is the signal, this is your 2, this is your minus 4. Now let us take this is suppose minus 4. This is 2, this is your minus 4. Now whatever the time you just consider, the signal values either 2 or minus 4. It cannot take all the amplitude values. It cannot take all the amplitude values, cannot be taken by the signal. So that means this amplitude value is not taken, this amplitude value is not taken, this amplitude value is not taken, this amplitude value is not taken. That means you have already defined the amplitude points are only these points. You cannot take any other point other than this. That means first of all you have defined a set, and within that set you are putting the amplitude points. Whenever you are plotting the signal or whenever you are discussing the signal amplitude values must either the points within the set, not actually all amplitude points you have to cover whenever you are discussing the signal. So therefore this type of signal is basically known as discrete amplitude signal, because you are taking discrete values of amplitudes, not actually all amplitude points we are taking over the amplitude axis whenever you are discussing the signal. So see, that means for this amplitude, you are having so many time points. This time point, this time point, this time point, this time point. That means whatever the time points you just consider, for every time points, the amplitudes either 2 or minus 4. If you consider this time point, amplitude is minus 4. If you consider this time point, amplitude is actually 2. Whatever the time you just consider, the amplitudes are having only 2 values. That is 2 or minus 4. It is very simple. That means this type of signal is nothing but known as a discrete amplitude signal. That means the time values are defined only at some predefined discrete amplitude points. Very interesting. Again, I am repeating, whenever you want to define discrete amplitude signal, you may say the definition in this manner. The time values are defined only for predefined
amplitude points. Not for all amplitude points the time values are defined. So therefore this particular signal is known as discrete amplitude signal. Now suppose I am having this signal in this way. Suppose I am drawing this signal. Now here this is suppose 1, you know this value is 0. So this time value 1, this time value 1, this time value 1, this time value 0. So that means whatever the time you just consider, the values are only 2, either 0 or 1. So therefore this is basically an amplitude, discrete amplitude signal. Understood? So this signal is discrete amplitude signal. This signal is discrete amplitude signal. But in case of continuous amplitude, suppose you are drawing this. Now whatever the time you just take, whatever the time you just consider, every time you are getting the amplitude value and the amplitude value is within a range. All the values within the range. That means this amplitude you can say time 0. This amplitude also you can say time 0. That means we are covering entire amplitude axis for defining the signal, for discussing the signal. So therefore this signal is a continuous amplitude signal, whereas this signal is discrete amplitude signal. It is very interesting and very important also. Because students are in confusion, which signal is a discrete amplitude signal and which signal is continuous amplitude signal. This signal is a continuous amplitude signal, this signal is discrete amplitude signal, because whenever you are defining these two, first of all you have to define a set, amplitude point set. So if you take amplitude points as all the points over the amplitude axis, then that is basically continuous amplitude. If you take amplitude set, is nothing but only discrete amplitude points. And we are saying that every point, only these two amplitude values exist. Then you can say that is basically discrete amplitude signal. So I think, is it clear? So anyway, so I have covered actually so many things. Continuous amplitude signal, discrete amplitude signal, continuous time signal, discrete time signal. In my next videos, also I will cover the combination of this. That means continuous time, continuous amplitude, continuous time, discrete amplitude, discrete time, continuous amplitude, discrete time, discrete amplitude. After then, I will say which signals are known as analog signals and which signals are known as digital signals. So please, time to time, see my videos and don't forget to subscribe. Please press the bell icon also, so that whatever the notification that will reach to you. Thank you very much.